How do you know if your home has a checkered history? Real estate agents do have to disclose material facts about a property, but does that include a murder that happened 50 years ago, a suicide that occurred recently, or a neighbour who deals meth? Because technically, for the most part, you're supposed to find those things out for yourself. When buying a property, there is so much you don't know.
Was it a drug lab? Has there been a homicide in the neighbourhood?
Has somebody died in the house? Two words for you. Buyers beware. It's a general principle for buying a house that basically translates to do your own research. That didn't happen in 2004 when an unknowing couple bought a Sydney house where three people had been murdered just 3 years before. But the agents that sold it to them were eventually fined for misleading behaviour under consumer protection laws and refunded the couple's $80,000 deposit. And that one seems clear. Buyers should be told about a crime like that, surely.
Clearly something like that needs to be disclosed to potential purchasers, not just if it happened yesterday.
Okay, but what if those crimes occurred 50 years ago or it's been lost to history?
And that's exactly the point. If it happened so long ago that nobody knows about it, then really what's the issue? Natural deaths occur in houses all the time and we don't disclose that, not surprisingly, because that's just part of the cycle of life. It gets a bit grey where we're starting to talk about things like suicides. At what point does a suicide become something that we should disclose or not disclose?
Well, as someone in the real estate business, how do you make the decision on how much and what to disclose?
The principle is still the same. If the issue with the property would cause a purchaser to say not purchase, then that's the thing that we need to tell them about.
But as Adrian Kelly mentioned, there are grey areas, and in those cases, it can still be up to the buyer to ask the question. Realistically though, who thinks to themselves when buying a house, I wonder if this house was a meth lab, I'd better ask. Victoria's laws are the most robust when it comes to material facts buyers should be told about. Last year, the state added murder and meth labs to the list and made it an offence not to tell. While in New South Wales it's similar, the events need to have occurred in the last 2 to 5 years. So should all laws be made clearer and more specific?
It's impossible to be too prescriptive with this. Somebody might have a problem with a meth lab and I totally get that, but what if somebody was dealing marijuana out their back door? Does that need to be disclosed?
Eileen Webb is a professor of law. She says it's a balance between agents disclosing and buyers asking the right questions. So what's the best way to get more information on properties? Like, how can you actually tell if your house was once a crime scene?
Just do some homework in the sense of maybe chatting to the neighbours, community centres, community newspapers and so on.
Okay, so what if you don't care that someone was killed in your house? Well, you might not, but others definitely will. Houses where someone's been murdered have been known to fall sharply in price. A UTS study even found that the value of houses nearby fell by nearly 4%. But it doesn't affect rentals, and after about a year or more, prices begin to return to normal. Though it does depend on the crime. 15 years after the Snowtown site was the dumping ground for 8 of the notorious bodies in barrels, buyers were encouraged to purchase a piece of Australian history. It sold for just under $200,000, whereas the Manson murder house in the US was demolished because it'd be unlikely to ever sell. That could be because disclosure laws in the US are much stronger than they are here. So strong, in fact, that they even include the sale of haunted houses. People have actually been released from contracts or sued for damages after buying haunted houses without being told. Now, our laws here aren't broad enough to apply to ghosts, but you could always ask. And look, there are plenty more things besides death and drugs and demons to look out for. Properties that are prone to flood or fire or built on contaminated land are going to be huge issues going forward. So it's definitely still worth the research and a few well-placed questions. Buyers beware after all.